Next topic is explaining the training example. So if I asked a question, explain or illustrate Prolog EBG algorithm. Prolog, it is nothing but a programming by logic, and EBG, it is nothing but an explanation based learning algorithm. So if I asked the question, illustrate Prolog EBG algorithm by using a save to stack example or save to stack domain theory, then you have to start from the previous video, that is video number 5 of illustration, and sorry, video number 4 and 5 of illustration, and then explanation of an example. So if I understand, if I ask the question, illustrate or explain an Prolog EBG algorithm by using a save to stack database or safe to stack domain theory, at that time you have to study from the video number 4, where I have explained about, or the illustration about, the safe to stack, which consisted of the 3 steps. One is an explanation, second one was analyzing, and third one was refining. So those 3 steps you have to explain. Next, you have to explain about the safe to stack domain theory, which is video number 5. And next, this video you have to refer. So as I explained in the previous video, the 3 steps in order to explain or in order to illustrate a Prolog EBG algorithm for a domain theory that is considered here as safe to stack. It consisted of 3 steps. First one is explaining the training example. Second one was analyzing the explanation. Next, third one was refining the current hypothesis by adding a new horn clauses. So these 3 steps we are going to study now in the future videos. So this carries 10 marks. All the 3 steps you have to explain. So the first step here is explaining the training example. So we know that the first step in processing the new training example, suppose if we take any of the new domain theory, the domain theory here, it consists of a training example. So the first step in processing and each of the training example here is to construct an explanation in terms of a domain theory. So we know that since we are studying an analytical learning, in an analytical learning, the training examples, if you are considering the training examples, it is converted into a set of an explanation for those training examples, and this explanation, it forms a domain theory. So that's why the first step in processing of a training example is to construct an explanation. So the first step here is construct an explanation in terms of the domain theory, showing how the positive example satisfies the target concept. We know that a positive example, it is nothing but if I consider an example of an enjoy sport, positive example is yes. So if it is yes or if it is true, then it is a positive, or else it is negative. Default is false here. So what is the first step? So the first step is to consider the training example. After considering the training example, you're going to construct an explanation for these training examples, and this forms a domain theory which also included or covered the positive example that satisfied the target concept. Now, we know that a domain theory is said to be correct and complete. Yes, so in the previous video, while explaining the need of a domain theory, I had explained the domain theory, it is said to be correct and it must be complete. The correct in the sense, all the assertions or all the declarations that is made, it must be true to the world, and complete when it covers the positive examples, and the unproven results or unproven target concept are considered as a default and it is a false example. So a domain theory, it must be correct and also it must be complete. So here in the same way, when the domain theory is correct and complete, this explanation, it constitutes a proof. So when we say that my domain theory, whatever the domain theory for safe to stack I have written, it is correct and it is complete, then there will be a proof for it. Correct? So there will be a proof for it that constitutes a proof that the training example satisfies the target concept. Now, when you are dealing with an, so see here, when you're dealing with an imperfect domain theory, or when you are dealing with an improper domain theory, or when you are dealing with an imperfect prior knowledge, then in such a case, we have to consider an imaginable or an approximate arguments rather than a perfect proof. So suppose when you have an imperfect prior knowledge or an imperfect domain theory, that default domain theory, it is considered to be as a negative, and in such a case we don't have an exact proof. So at that time we will go for an imaginable or an approximate arguments rather than the perfect proofs. Correct? So I hope you understood what is an explanation. So what is the first step here? In the first step, I'm going to consider the training example, and then I'm going to write the explanation for it, and the explanation forms the domain theory here. The domain theory, it must be correct and complete. When it is correct and complete, you will be having a proof for a positive target concept. When you have an imperfect domain theory or an imperfect domain knowledge, then approximation is going to be performed, or imaginable proofs you are going to consider rather than the perfect proofs. The explanation of this safe to stack, it is shown in this figures. So I'll show the figure here. Correct? So this is a diagram. So for one, diagram one, and this is a diagram two. So you have to draw both the diagrams. Okay? So understand now. So the bottom of this figure here means this figure. It depicts or it explains the graphical form, the positive training example safe to stack, object 1 comma object 2. Here you have considered the two variables, one is an object 1 and next is of an object 2. So you have to write the two diagrams. Now what is this object 1 indicates? See here, object 1 here, it indicates about, refer the video number 5 where I have explained about the example safe to stack and a domain theory. The same thing here it is written. So object 1, so if I show you, so if I show you this example, you can see here, so this is an object 1. So in object 1, it is a box, type is a box, and object 1 color is red, object 1 volume is 2, the owner of object 1 is Fred, the owner of next, the material of object 1 is cardboard. So the same way the object 2, and are written in the form of a predicate. In the form of a predicate, in the sense it is nothing but a logical relationships, it is written here. As I told, it is a bottom to top approach of explanation, of writing an explanation. Since it is written in the form of a predicate or in a logical relationship, it is a bottom to top approach it is following. Means the top one, it indicates the target, and the bottom explanation, it indicates about how we have arrived or how we have reached at the top target concept. So now let's see the explanation diagram. So this is an explanation diagram. As I told, object 1 here, object 1, you can see the material, it is cardboard, the color is red, owner is Fred, and its type is box, volume is 2, and density is 0.3. The same way the object 2 is written. So this forms one particular domain and this forms other particular domain, and both are interrelated since it comes under a complete domain theory of safe to stack. So as I told, the bottom of the figure, it depicts the positive form of a training example, whereas the top figure, now let's come to the top figure. So this is the top diagram. Here you can see that stack object 1 comma 2, that is the top one, it indicates the target concept, and how I have achieved at the target concept. As I told, it is a bottom to top approach. So you're going to start from the bottom, that is an object 1 volume. Since we know that the main aim here is to find out which object 1 is lighter or object 2 is lighter. So we are comparing the objects based on their material, based on their type, and since it is related to weight, so weight in turn related to volume and density. So that we have return. So whatever it is written in the domain theory, the same thing it is written in the form of a depiction of a bottom to top approach. The top one, that is safe to stack, here it indicates about the target concept, and the bottom one or the bottom leaves, it indicates the predicates or an interrelationship. Okay, now the top of the figure here depicts the explanation constructed for this training example. Notice that how the explanation written here is. The safe to stack object 1 on object 2. In the sense, object 1 is related to an object 2. Okay, object 2 on, or you can say that since it is a cardboard, so understand the relation. We have considered object 1 as a cardboard and object 2 as the box here, correct? And on here it indicates, and since it is a box, so it provides the relationship how the cardboard is placed on that particular box which is made of wood. So that is a relation indicated. Understand how the cardboard is kept on the box which is made of wood, that is shown here. Now let's understand the explanation part of this. Okay, so we know that a safe to stack object 1 on object 2, it is a target concept. Here object 1 is lighter when compared to the object 2. How means object 1 is known to be lighter. How it is related is object 1 is known to be lighter, okay, when compared to an object 2, because its weight can be inferred from its density and volume, and also the object 2 weight is inferred from its density and volume. Here you can see that only a single explanation is given for the training example, and a domain theory is also shown in the particular example. Now in general, if there are multiple possible explanation, then in such a case all the explanations must be used, and it must be written in the form of this flow diagram or in the form of a tree structure. Correct. So this may give rise to a generalization of a training example. So thus, in case of a prologue EBG, the explanation is generated using a backward chaining search as performed by prologue, that is programming by logic. Prologue EBG, like a prologue, it is going to halt once it finds the valid proof. So until it finds the valid proof, this tree will be keep on building. See, here I have considered only one explanation, that is lighter explanation I have considered from my example. So, and I am comparing here. So object 1 is lighter or object 2 is lighter. So we know that object lighter, it is related to a weight, and weight in turn related to the volume and density. And by seeing this, I came to the conclusion that you can see here the weight of object 1 is 0.6 and the weight of object 2 is 5. So from this, I'll conclude that the object 1 is lighter than compared to the object 2 when I write it in the form of this diagram. So this is for a single explanation, that is lighter explanation I have considered. Like this, many such explanation will be present. Correct? So many such explanation you can consider from the particular domain theory and draw or generalize this diagram. So you're going to build this tree structure diagram until you get a valid proof. When you get a valid proof, then you say that it is a positive example and it is going to be correct and it is going to be complete. Correct? So this is about an explaining the training example. Let's revise it again. So what are the key points in explaining the training example? So understand here, explaining the training example, the first step here, you're going to construct So you're going to construct here, by considering the training example, the domain theory. So what is the domain theory? The domain theory, it is knowledge on the particular field where you'll be having the explanation of the training examples, correct? So that is the first step. Next, what you're going to do, when you have built your domain theory, you're going to check whether your domain theory is correct or complete. So correct and complete, when you say, is correct when the declaration or the assertion what you have made, it is true to the whole world. So example I have taken here is, if I say that there is a gravitational force, it must be applied to the whole world, correct? And completeness here, it indicates that it covers a positive example of a target concept, and default, it considers the negative examples. So when you get a perfect proof, then you say that the domain theory is correct and complete. When you have an imperfect prior knowledge or an imperfect domain theory, then you are going to consider an imaginable things and you go for an approximating, and you will say with an, and you will manage with an imperfect proof, and you are going to complete until you get the perfect proof. So next is a diagram explanation. So in the diagram, you have to write the two diagram. So this is the first diagram, which is about the tree structure. Next is a mapping diagram. Here the object 1 predicates have been written. Next is an object 2 predicates has been written. So on it is an interrelation between object 1 and object 2, and you are seeing that the cardboard is placed on the box which is made up of an wooden material. Now you are going to compare the explanation, the how the explanation must be written is. Here I have considered only the one explanation, that is lighter, and I'm trying to find out object 1 is lighter or object 2 is lighter. So here, in order to find out that, I have considered the weight of both. Now since weight is related to volume and the density, and I have taken the volume and the density, and I have written, I have also written the predicates because it gives a relationship between the each of the objects. Here I have considered only a single explanation. Like this, multiple explanations will be present. So when you have a multiple explanation, then in such a case you are going to, when you have a multiple explanation, then you are going to generalize the training example and generalize this diagram. You are going to generalize this diagram, and you are going to continue to write the bottom-up approach unless you get a perfect proof. When you get a perfect proof, you will say that your domain theory is correct and complete. So this is about the first step, that is explaining the training example. Let's see the next step, that is analyzing the explanation.